Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you how you can design your messenger flows to continue even when a user types versus taps. We all know the scenarios where we ask a user, hey, tap on the button below, but instead of tapping, they start typing. And in that scenario, if you didn't anticipate for that behavior, your flow will come to a halt. Most likely your default reply kicks in, user gets confused, overall bad user experience. Now, with what I'm going to show you now, you are able to make your flows truly conversational. Your drop-off rates will decrease and you will instantly improve the UX of your flows. Now, once you understand how you can set up this simple structure, you will never want to do it differently again. Now, I'm going to show you two examples. I'm going to show you an example of an order update message. Somebody replies to an order update message. And I'm going to show you the example where we want to verify an email or a phone number. Both scenarios where you do not want your flow to come to a halt. Both scenarios where you actually want to leverage the conversation. In this case, to get reviews on specific channels or to verify an email or a phone number so you can use that in an omni-channel marketing strategy to keep the conversation going with your subscribers. Now, I'm going to show you the scenario here when somebody replies to the order has been delivered message. Full disclosure, this first part is AI enhanced, but everything beyond this you can actually build natively in Manychat or whatever channel you're using. So let's say the user replies with got it and love it. User replied, bot picked up the intent. Fantastic. We're so glad you loved your experience with us. Now, we want to leverage this intent. We want to make sure that the flow continues. Now, when the user taps the button, sure, great. The flow will go on. But if they would type something, I'm just going to type something random here. So let's say, yo, 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 yo. Normally, if you didn't anticipate on this behavior, your flow would come to a grinding halt. But what we've done now is we actually build in what I call a retry. And I'm going to show you exactly how to do that in a little bit. Okay, so in this case, the bot replies, hey, please tap on or type sure below. Now, I'm going to show you how this works. I'm going to type yes. Now, the bot understands that the user wants to continue. And it replies, thank you so much. Would you be able to take some time out of your day to write a review on wherever? As you can see here, the bot actually continued based on the input from the user. And I'm going to show you now how you can actually build this directly into Manychat. Right on. So let's have a look at the canvas here. So by default, you probably built your flows with these, what we call nodes. This is just a text block with, in this case, a button, a quick reply, or you can add a button. This is how you would set it up by default. But what you would have to do in order to understand the user input, what we need to do, so instead of using a text block like this, what we're gonna do is we're gonna throw in a user input block, just like this. And what we're going to do, we're going to select the user input block and we're going to make the reply type. We're going to make it multiple choice. And then when we've chosen multiple choice, we're going to select also allow free text input. Now what happens, we can actually add the call to action buttons down here. Let's say sure. We can add the call to action buttons right there. Now what happens when we set multiple choice and also allow free text input, the multiple choice actually enables us to add quick reply buttons, and the also allow free text input will enable the bot to actually understand when somebody types versus taps. So multiple choice, allow free text input. When you've done so, and I'm going to show you this, this is the actual live flow that I just demonstrated to you. What we're doing is, so we have this user input block, multiple choice, free text input, the actual call to action button is there. But this action block here, that actually automatically continues when the bot received some kind of input, what this will do, this will set a custom field. This is, you can use one specific custom field for this. And as with custom fields, you would create those custom fields yourself. So I named it type recover. What I'm going to do is I'm going to add the last text input. And this is a standard Manychat field. I'm going to use the last text input to populate this custom field. So whatever happens here, the last text input will be populated in the custom field type recover. So when I type something, that value will be populated in the custom field type recover. Then we have conditional logic block that actually looks if the value in the type recover custom field contains specific words. And this is where the beauty, where it all comes together. You decide what those words are. First things first, what you need to do, let's assume that the majority of the people tap versus type. So what we need to do, if there's a word in there, in this case it's sure, make sure that the words you're using at least contain the word that is included in the quick reply. Now, in order to prevent the flow from coming to a halt with, let's say, random user input, make sure that you're adding words in there that you know or expect somebody could type in that would have the same intent. So in this case, it would be yes. Hey, would you like to leave a review? Yes. Great. Should continue. Okay. Great. Should continue. And when it continues, then when the conditional logic block actually sees that the custom field input, the custom field, the value in the custom field contains one of these words, it will actually move to the next flow. And this is how you make sure that your bot is smarter than all the other bots out there and it doesn't come to a grinding halt, because I guarantee you people will type something here. They will type sure, they will type yes. And if you do not anticipate on that behavior, if you do not populate that user input in a custom field, and if you do not use a conditional logic block to actually understand or look for specific words in the custom field, your flow is coming to a halt. You will not be able to leverage this conversation to get a customer review. Now, in the scenario that somebody types something that isn't relevant at all, that doesn't match the condition block, we're gonna try one more time, which I showed you in my example. So a little bit of a different copy here. So, hey, please tap on or type sure below. Again, we sort of refocus the subscriber here, we refocus the user, and we tell them once more exactly what they need to do. We have the same condition block right there. So even if they tap, great, they move forward. If they type, they move forward as well. If they do it wrong again, we hand them off to a human. Two strikes, in this case, you're out, and then we'll hand it over to a human, and then a human can take over. So this is the scenario where we ask for a customer review. Now, then there's another scenario, very common scenario, I have to say, is where we ask for email addresses and phone numbers. Why do we ask for email addresses and phone numbers? We want to use that information in our omnichannel marketing strategies to re-engage our subscribers. So in this scenario, somebody comes in, we're going to confirm the email. Hey, let's get you subscribed to occasional SMS updates. It looks like I will be sending an email to whatever email address I have on file. If somebody goes on, say, hey, tap yes to confirm or no to update. Again, here, somebody, and this is real life, people will type yes or nope or anything like that. If that happens, you didn't anticipate on it, your flow comes to a halt. So same scenario here, we have a user input block, multiple choice, allows free text input. We have the same action block where we populate the custom field type recover with the actual last text input from this user. So if the last text input from this user was yes, the B4E type recover custom field value would be yes. The condition block would recognize it, and then boom, they will be off. They will be off to the next flow. Simple as that. And the beauty of this is you can sort of copy this just like this and have it in a separate folder in your Manychat account, so you can always copy and paste it wherever you are, whatever flows you're working in, so you do not continuously have to retype this or sort of set up that condition block. I have two or three scenarios in specific folders which I can copy in any flow I'm working with. Just makes it a little bit more efficient. And I hope that you will implement this into your builds so you can actually improve the overall user experience of your flows. If you got any questions, do make sure you drop a comment below this video. And as always, I will get back to you as soon as possible.